We're going to work through a rate of wind problem. A jet flying with a tailwind traveled 1680 miles in 3 hours. Flying against the wind, it traveled 1960 miles in 4 hours. Find the rate of the jet in still air and the rate of the wind. Now, there is more than one way to do this problem, but I'm going to start out with the traditional method, and if I have time, I'll show you another way of looking at it. So we're looking for the rate of the jet in still air and the rate of the wind, so we need to begin by defining those two variables, or a variable for each of those. So I'm going to let x represent the rate of the jet in still air. There we go. And w, the rate of the wind. So we're going to make up a chart to fill in the information we know from this problem. So going with the wind, the jet is really getting the rate of the jet in still air plus the little extra wind. The tailwind means it's behind you, it's helping push you through the air. So this will be x plus w. And going against the wind, that means you're going into the wind, and so you're not going quite as fast. That'll be x minus w. All right, what does this tell us about going with the wind? It said it traveled 1,680 miles in 3 hours. So the time was 3 hours, and the distance was 1,680. Flying against the wind, it traveled 1,960 miles in 4 hours. So this gives rise to two equations if we use the formula rate times time equals distance. So our next step would be to write those two equations. All right, so for the first equation, x plus w times 3, which I'm going to write as 3 times x plus w, is equal to 1680. And the second equation, it's rate times time, using the information about the jet going against the wind, is 4 times x minus w equals 1960. Now, you can do the distributive property, but then your coefficients for x's, one of them will be 3, one of them will be 4, and for the w's, one of them will be 3, one of them will be 4, or a negative 4 actually. And so you'll have to do more work with the distributive property. I'm sorry, you're going to have to do more work using the addition method. My suggestion is to divide both sides by the coefficient here of 3 on the first equation. So the 3's cancel, and I have just what x plus w equals. And then we simply divide. So that's going to be 560. And for the other equation, the second equation, I'm going to multiply both sides by 4. Now I'm really dividing the whole thing by 4. You could extend this if you'd like, the fraction bar, but basically you want the 3's to cancel out in the first equation, the 4's to cancel out in the second equation, so that I get simpler equations. All right, so we have two equations, x plus w equals 560 and x minus w equals 490. And if we use the addition method, note that the w's will cancel out. So I'm just going to put the x minus w equals 490 under here. And if I add the two equations, I get 2x equals 1050. And then you're going to divide both sides by 2. So we will get x equals 525. Now, let's see. What did x stand for? It stood for the rate of the jet in still air. So we now know the rate of the jet in still air. We need to find w, the rate of the wind. So we could plug in 525 into one of these equations. How about since x minus w is sitting there, we can put in 525 for x right there if you'd like. And then let's see, to solve for w, I'm going to add w to both sides. So I'm going to have a w on the right side. And then I'm going to subtract 490 from both sides. So I'll subtract 490 from both sides. And that will give me, and I also added w, I guess I should show that. going to add W to both sides. So what does that give me? That gives me 35. Okay, so I got W is 35. That's the rate of the wind. That seems reasonable. But of course, we're not sure. We've got to check our answers and go back to the original words to see if these make sense. All right, here was the original problem, and we came up that x was 525, and that was the rate of the jet in stall air. So we got 525 miles per hour for the rate of the jet in stall air, and 35 miles per hour, that was W, which stood for the rate of the wind. Now we want to make sure that this makes sense given the original words. So it said a jet flying with the tailwind traveled 1,680 miles in 3 hours. So we're going to check. All right. If it was going with the tailwind, it would be 525 plus 35. So it really would be going through the air at 560 miles per hour. That's its rate. And what, for 3 hours? And then you multiply 560 times 3, and we get 1,680. And it does say we were supposed to go 1,680 miles. So that checks. Now we're going to check the second part. Flying against the wind, it traveled 1,960 miles. Okay, against the wind, well, it's in stellar, it went 525. We're going to subtract the wind's distance because it's really going through the air then at 490 miles an hour. And it's going for 4 hours. And so we multiply that out. We get 1960. Looking back up, it was 1960. So this does make sense that this is the answer. All right, I'm going to show you just another way of thinking about this exact same problem. So here's the problem again, and we still need to find out the rate of the jet in stellar air and the rate of the wind. So we could start off with the x being the rate of the jet in stellar air and w the rate of the wind. But instead of writing a chart, we might think about it a little bit differently. We know the rate, the actual rate going with the wind, is x plus w. We also know the rate going against the wind is x minus w. So that's the actual rate going through the air. Now, what would its rate be? Well, remember the rate times time equals distance? So if you wanted to solve for rate, you could divide both sides by t. And that tells you that the rate is simply the distance over the time. Okay, so then let's look at this problem, the first sentence. A jet flying with the wind traveled 1,680 miles in 3 hours. So you know what? Going with the wind, if we put its distance over its time, we would just write 1,680 over 3. That's really the same thing as the rate going with the wind, right? Because it says flying with the wind, it went 1,680 miles in 3 hours. Going against the wind, well, we know that means x minus w is its rate. But another way to get the rate is you do the distance over time. So we would do 1,960 over 4. And this gives us the same two equations that we had previously. If we just divide, 1,680 divided by 3 is, I think, 560, right? And 1,960 divided by 4 was 490. So there's another way to get those two equations without writing it with the distributive property, without doing a chart. You're just thinking about it a little bit differently. There's a lot of ways to come up with the equations that'll help you solve the problem. But in the end, remember it's a word problem. You want to answer the problem in words. So from here, you could still go through and solve the rest of the problem exactly the same way we did before. Also, you would check exactly the same way, and you would write the answer to the problem the same way. So again, we would, after we solve it, we're still going to get that the rate of the jet was 525 miles per hour, the rate of the wind was 35 miles per hour, and our check should still make sense. We're going to take the actual rate times its time equals the distance given and make sure it all checks out.